Hi all, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at the PLT850 gas analyzer from the TOOLTOP brand, which has four separate sensors. For flammable gases X, for carbon monoxide, for hydrogen sulfide and for oxygen. The sensor data is displayed on the screen, and if the parameters go beyond safe standards, an alarm is triggered. An alarm sounds, a light signal works, a vibration signal works. And a voice tells which sensor has been triggered. In the video I will show you why it is needed and how to use this device. The manufacturer claims that the device uses high-quality imported gas sensors with excellent sensitivity. I will leave a link to the device in the description if you are interested in measuring instruments. Then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. The detector is widely used in petroleum, chemical industry, environmental protection, metallurgy, oil refining, agriculture, fire protection and other industries and places where safety monitoring for toxicity and harmfulness and explosion prevention is required. The detector can effectively predict the concentration of hazardous gases and issue an alarm to ensure the safety of people and equipment. It may be useful to you to ensure your safety. The device comes in such a beautiful box. The box is reinforced with iron corners and aluminum corners. Judging by the sticker, one of the customers for this device is in Spain. Let me remove the sticker, so it doesn't spoil the look of the box. There is a carrying handle and a latch. Unfasten the latch. Open the box. For some reason they gave me two passports, they are both in English. Everything in the box is neatly packed. I especially like the protective seal on the lid. This box was not indicated on the sales page. The fact that the device came in such a box was a pleasant bonus for me. Let's look at the equipment of the device, and then the device itself. The kit includes a 5-volt, 2.4-amp charger. There is also a cord for it with USB and micro USB connectors. There is also an adapter that allows you to connect a gas hose to the device to all sensors at once. I draw your attention to how the device itself lies in the box. It is well protected from impacts. In addition, the device itself has a shockproof housing. You should still avoid dropping the device. The case has an IP65 protection rating, which allows you to work with it even in light rain, and it is not afraid of dust. All four sensors are located on the front panel. The display is backlit and the device is controlled by three buttons. There is a warning light on top. There is a micro USB charging input covered with a rubber plug. The battery inside the device allows you to use the device for at least 10 hours. It is recommended to charge the device when switched off. Let's close. At the rear is the speaker output. There are also two fastenings here. Such a latch for a pocket or belt. It latches quite tightly. There is a loop for hanging the device on a cord. If desired, this mount can be removed by unscrewing the screw behind this hole. On this plate you can see the measurement range of this device for each sensor and battery characteristics. To turn on the device, press the middle button for 3 seconds.
Welcome to Use Intelligent Voice Gas Detector. Starting, please wait.
The device greets you with a voice and performs self-diagnosis, including checking the light signal and vibration. Since the device is calibrated when turned on, it should be turned on in clean air. Immediately after switching on, the device shows the configured alarm values for each type of gas, and only then shows the reading levels for each sensor. We press the left button and we can see the battery charge of the device, how long it has been turned on, time and date. We switch again to the sensor readings. With the right button, we get to the device menu, but I'll look at it later. Now let's see what the device measures and why is it needed. H2S is hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide is formed during the rotting of protein products. It is also found in volcanic gases. In industrial production, hydrogen sulfide is obtained during the purification of petroleum gases as a byproduct. Its toxic concentrations accumulate in gutters, garbage pits, and coal mines. Hydrogen sulfide is a very toxic gas, inhaling it in high concentrations can cause cardiac paralysis and lead to death. Lower concentrations cause convulsions, pulmonary edema, and paralysis of the olfactory nerve. We can smell this smell ourselves. It is the smell of rotten eggs or rotting meat. This device displays its concentration in ppm. 1 ppm is 1 part gas per million parts clean air. By default, the alarm is triggered at 15 ppm. If desired, the alarm level can be set to a different one, but more on that later. O2 oxygen, its standard concentration in the air is 20.9%. Both a lack of oxygen and a high concentration are dangerous. If the concentration drops below 19.5%, rapid breathing and dizziness begin. And less than 7% leads to coma or death. If 23.5% is exceeded, there is a risk of ignition. If the oxygen concentration goes beyond 19.5 to 23.5%, the device triggers an alarm. CO, carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is colorless and odorless. It usually forms if the gas equipment has poor draft, or the damper of the stovepipe is closed before the coals burn out. I have heard more than once cases where people were poisoned by carbon monoxide due to improper handling of heating appliances. If symptoms of carbon monoxide poisoning appear, weakness, drowsiness, rapid heartbeat, you must immediately leave the room for air. If this is not done, death from suffocation is possible. In the house, you should open the window and ventilate the room. The device measures the gas concentration in ppm and an alarm is triggered at 50 ppm. X is the name given to flammable gases. They are highly flammable, toxic, and can cause poisoning to humans and animals. There are 25 most common flammable gases. In everyday life, we often encounter them, like natural gas in pipes and cylinders. Initially, this gas is odorless, and so that people can detect a leak with their sense of smell. Additives are added to it, the smell of which we smell during leaks. Gas of natural origin, which can accumulate in gorges, basements, and mines. We cannot detect by smell. This device is used to detect it. The alarm is triggered when the concentration of this gas exceeds 20 lel. And lel is the minimum concentration of a flammable explosive substance. In a homogeneous mixture with clean air at which a bang, fire, or explosion is possible. That is, if the concentration reaches 100%, an explosion is possible. A very common situation occurs when dangerous gases accumulate in the cellar. As a result of the decay of organic matter, oxygen is completely burned, but methane and carbon dioxide appear. And therefore, it is better to lower this gas analyzer there before going into the cellar. In case of danger, the device will work either due to a lack of oxygen or to methane. This is X gas. It should be taken into account that the device must be kept in the measured environment for at least 30 seconds. Let's try it out. I'll blow on the oxygen sensor now.
Attention please, oxygen gas concentration exceeded. Attention please, oxygen gas low concentration.
The oxygen level dropped and the alarm went off. It should be noted that the instrument readings are inert. I blew on the device for more than 30 seconds to get the sensor to work. But after removing the device from the measured environment, the readings of the device do not change immediately, but gradually. I also tested the device on natural gas. For some time I held this device over an open burner of a gas stove. I will only note that I felt the gas with my nose immediately. And the readings of the X-gas sensor changed gradually. I brought the sensor readings to 10% and did not go further, because I did not want to breathe natural gas myself. And I don't want to repeat this experiment on camera. If there are odor additives in the gas, then we will detect a leak faster with our nose than with this device. This adapter is connected in this way. We can connect a gas hose here. Then the gas will be analyzed by four sensors at once. This adapter is also used to calibrate the device. Personally, I'm unlikely to use this adapter. And let's look at the menu now. Press the right button. If it asks for a password, the default is 4 ones. The first menu item is recorded values. Let's choose. Press the middle button. Use the left to right buttons to scroll through the recorded values. The device displays the parameter that was triggered, its level and when the trigger occurred. We can remove unnecessary values. The next menu item is setting the lower alarm threshold. Click. We select for which sensor we set the threshold. We select and use the left and right buttons to adjust this value. Adjusted, press enter and confirm. The next step is setting the upper trigger level. Works the same as the previous point.
Successfully saved.
The next item is zero adjustment. This item must be used with extreme caution. The zero of each sensor is adjusted separately. This item is password protected. By default, this password is 4 units. The next point is calibrating the device. It is also password protected. And non-professional personnel are prohibited from performing it. The device is initially calibrated at the factory. Next is setting the date and time. I would like to note that the date is displayed in the device in an unusual way for a Russian person. First the year, then the month, then the date. Use the middle button to scroll through the values, and use the left and right buttons to adjust the value. Confirm the setting and exit to the main menu. Next, select the backlight mode. Let's choose normal mode, when the backlight is on constantly. If we turn on auto mode, the backlight turns off automatically after 30 seconds. When we do not press the buttons. The next item is setting up a password. To do this, you need to enter your old password. I won't change it. If you decide to change your password, remember it well, or better yet, write it down. If you forget it, it can only be reset at the factory. Next is information for each sensor, the lower and upper alarm levels, as well as the upper level to which the device can measure. The next point is choosing a language. There are two languages, Chinese and English. There is no Russian language here. Moreover, if you switch to Chinese, even the voice acting will be in Chinese. My device originally came in Chinese. And it is quite difficult to navigate the menu if the device shows hieroglyphs. After studying the instructions, I was still able to switch the device to English, and now I'll show you how. In case the device also comes with a Chinese menu. Let's choose. Let's remember. Now the device speaks Chinese. These are the icons that appear on the display. What does it take to switch to English? We enter the menu. We're looking for a screen like this. Let's go in. We choose the English menu. Click. We confirm. And we return to the English menu again. Then just exit the menu. There are no settings in the device to turn off light, vibration and sound alarms. You have to come to terms with this. Long press the middle key, confirm and the device is turned off. Here is such a device. It has added to the arsenal of devices that I use to ensure my safety. I will use it in practice, because I believe that there are times in life when it is necessary. I talked about the capabilities of the device, and about the gases that it also measures. If I missed something, write in the comments. I like both the capabilities of the device and the box that comes with it. If you have any questions, write in the comments. You can find additional information about the device at the link where I ordered the device. The link is in the description. Share the video with your friends to protect them from gas poisoning. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Like and see you in new and old videos.